Hello, 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 it's Joe. That should be my new theme song. Hello, 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 it's Joe. All right, we are going to write a humor column, start to finish. It won't be a long one, probably 250 words. It may not even be that good. But it'll be done, and that's more than 95% of the world right now doing the same thing. Mine will be done. All right, so a house. How about this? A house in Malibu, California. Let's find the article, and then we'll take off on it. Malibu house sold for $110 million. This was just this last week. Malibu, if you don't know, is a suburb of LA, where a lot of rich people live. All right, here we go. Here's the headline. This is from the Los Angeles Times. $110 million home sale in Malibu is set to be a new record for Los Angeles County. So this is from the LA Times. Oh, it's on Billionaire's Beach. Hotelier Peter Morton has an agreement in place to sell his oceanfront property to natural gas billionaire. it just moves down Billionaire Row. Michael S. Smith and his wife, Iris. Astronomical sale, even in the world of luxury real estate. The previous record was $100 million, which was hit twice in 2016, one of which was the Playboy Mansion. So in Malibu, two $85 million sales closed in the last year and a half. LA, man. There are never going to be that many huge sales in Malibu because there are only so many homes, said Jack Pritchett, co-founder of Malibu-based brokerage. Okay, so we get the idea. It doesn't really matter that it's at Malibu, but the $110 million is. So what do you get? What do you get for that? So let's just make it simple, and we'll just say, hold on a second. I might need something to write on. Let's just say three things you get. Let's do it the other way. $110 million home sale in Malibu sets county record. Could you say California? California record? Yeah, let's just say county record. Let's say LA County. That's what people will recognize, LA. Let's just say LA. LA record, which is LA County and LA are basically the same thing, more or less. There's construction going on outside, but we'll live through it. $110 million sale in Malibu sets LA record. Here is what you get. Three amazing things the new buyer gets. That's not a very good headline, but let's just go with it for now. We can change it. So, a beachfront home in Malibu sold recently for $110 million. A record for LA County in California. You don't even need that in California. So, a record for LA County. Should you capitalize county in that case? LA County? No, LA County. And Malibu, I don't know. The previous record was 100, was two homes, was held. The previous record was held by two homes that sold, that each sold for 100 million, Jesus Christ, in 2016, one of which was the Playboy Mansion. What do you get? What does a home worth 110 milli? I'm not usually the slang guy or the, but makes it a little more casual. What does a home worth 110 milli have that makes it cost more? Okay, so here's where we could put in a joke that costs more. And again, the jokes don't have to be funny. But they should feel the, you know, we could always go back and rework it. So what does a home worth 110 milli have that makes it cost more than, so what would be something that expensive? So for example, you could say, here's a bad one. You could say, what does a home worth 110 milli have that makes it cost more than what Ryan Seacrest spends on hair gel every year? You know, something that bad. Could go with that, but we could come up with an even better, worse joke, a better bad joke. So, you know, it's, Trump is always an easy target. Costs more than Trump spends on, you know, Twitter buttons. spends on hot air fees. Costs more than. So here you're looking, you're kind of looking for somebody that's well known, and then or something that's in the news a lot. So, for example, millennials. What does it cost more than an average millennial spends on, you know, self-esteem tapes? Self-esteem, millennial will go, what's a tape? Then the Kanye West spends on, then Kim Kardashian spends on mirrors. That's not bad. That's bad. But what does a home worth 110 milli have more, have that makes it cost more than what Kim Kardashian spends on mirrors? Here are three things. So that was pretty bad, right? But we'll fix it. Here are three, you know, unique things. Here are three amazing things that will make you want to work harder than the, again, another joke, the 22 out of the 22 hours you work every week 22 hours you work every week out of the 40 you spend at your office. Okay. It's another weak joke, but so let's just make it easy. Let's go with headline. The subhead will be the title of the unique things you get for. So that's the joke of the whole. These are the jokes of the whole premise. So in other words, what crazy things might you have in a house worth $110 million? Well, it's L.A., and it's Malibu, and it's on Billionaire's Beach. So who might live on Billionaire's Beach that's maybe a crazy billionaire? So you could say next door status to... Ryan Seacrest, no. And next door status to a hotline to Barack Obama. So this is a liberal's town. So let's go with that Barack Obama hotline. Secret. Barack Obama. Hotline, kind of like the bad phone. Secret hotline. All right. So liberal LA has many, there are many Barack Obama supporters. We have to say liberal Barack Obama supporters in LA, but none has a direct line to the former president like you will, like this house, like the owner of this house. Hidden behind a picture of Hillary Clinton in the first floor library is a secret panel, secret passageway leading to the Barack Obama hotline. Hidden, we already use hidden, is the emergency liberal LA. We might have to say liberal LA. Maybe not everybody knows LA is very liberal. First floor library. Let's see. The hotline is to be used when things get so bad. So to complete the thought, you could say when things get bad enough under Trump. You could say under Trump or just bad enough. Well, what if you just said when things get bad enough? Enter. Let's see, there are many presently hidden by the owner of this house. When things get bad enough, the owner can enter the password. When things get bad enough, the owner can call for call Obama for, advice, for answers, for vital answers to current societal problems, and get so what you could say, just to make it silly, you could say, keep in mind current societal problems. Well, what I was going to say was, you could say, well, if one of the daughters answers and says, "Dad, it's for you," something like that, but nobody does that anymore. Nobody answers the phone and he goes, "It's for you." Everybody has their own phone. So, when things get, the owner can call Obama for vital answers to current societal problems. It's silly, but it's not really making a very good comedic point, in terms of liberal LA or Obama, or it doesn't hit, there's not a target, there's not really a target. Trump would be the obvious target. So what if you did it that way? When things get bad enough under Trump, how about if things get bad enough? You can say if and when, but let's just say if things get bad enough under Trump, plus it kind of dates it, but that's it. The owner can call Obama for his, can call Obama. The owner can call Obama for insight, or you could do it the other way. You could say the owner can call Obama and have him chopper into the roof for emergency meetings. Something like that. We already used the word emergency, leading to the, you don't want to use the same word. What if you called it the red phone, the Barack Obama red phone hotline, encased under glass, encased in bulletproof glass. If things get bad enough under Trump, the owner can call Obama and have him chopper in, and have him chopper into the roof for an emergency meeting. Instead of emergency meetings, an emergency meeting, singular. All right, it's not very good. But the point of this whole video is just to complete a first draft, I guess you could say. Wonder how much all the way into. Oh man, this thing is way too long now. So we gotta get it going. It's 19 minutes in. Oh, it's taking too long. So let's not make it's bad, but let's not even worry about that. And let's worry less about that. Let's just finish it. So, all right. So what else would you have in a $110 million house? You would have, so all these billionaires have been building bunkers in New Zealand. That's the rumor. So New Zealand bunker, let's just do it. Bunker, underground bunker. Sure, the world is, I don't type, going to hell in a hand basket. What do you care? When the zombies take over, and overrun Los Angeles. Parentheses. How would you tell the difference? You and your family can run down to your underground apocalypse bunker to underground bunker staff, what do you call it, stored, equipped is the word. I didn't say I was good with words. Equipped with 2 years worth of, now here's where we can do a dumb joke, worth of 2 years worth of food, food, water, and modern family reruns. Yeah, it doesn't make any sense, but it's a comedic detail that needs to be fixed. The whole thing needs to be fixed. All right, what if you just stop there? Let's just say we would just want to finish. All right, so now underground bunker, secret Barack Obama hotline, and you're rich. Bacardi B is rich. Bacardi B, rapper. We've already kind of used the secret phone and underground bunker. What would just be something that would be day to day? So day to day, if you were super rich, you might have like 15 cars. There's a guy that was in the news today. He collects Ferraris. He keeps them in underneath a shopping mall, 40 miles from LA. So let's say you're that guy and you had 50 cars. So let's exaggerate. Let's say you had a 150 car garage. 150 car garage. No self-respecting billionaire has anything less than 100 cars. Let's make it 200. Let's make it 350 car garage. That's too high. Let's go 247 car garage. Has anything less than that car? Because 100 cars may not be that many for a billionaire. 247 car garage. You, the owner, see, already the tense is wrong. There's a lot of problems with this. Let's call this a first draft. The owner of this mega mansion on the beach can store up to 247 cars on the property, in the garage, in the expansive garage. There are special, there are special spaces for golf carts, motorcycles, and there are special spaces for golf carts, motorcycles, and you could say your ego, and an expanded, this is a really bad joke, expanded 5-car wide space to accommodate their ego. you know, like, you know, billionaires have a big ego or obnoxious ego. It's not very good. Let's just go with it. So what was the point of this whole thing? The point of it was just to complete a humor column, and put it out, and to record me doing it. Why? I have no idea. I just thought it would be interesting. So I'll come back later to fix it. But at least it's a starting point. It's sort of hacky. You know, his ego, you know, the third joke is about a billionaire's ego. I'm like, what? And the bunker thing has been played, you know. Yes, rich people have bunkers. But a lot of times I find, I don't know, maybe you're different if you're a writer or a comedian. I find it's better just to write a bad article and then go back than try to, you know, be so precious about it. Because then what happens is, so often, it never gets done at all. You might think, well, why would you put, why, you know, who cares if it's done? Well, that's what I'm saying. You might say, who cares if it's done? Wait till it's better. That's the thing. People wait and wait and wait and wait and wait and wait and wait. So would this be under, so I'm gonna find a WordPress category for it here. LA Life. How about Home and Garden? Just under Home and Garden. So I'm on my third problems book. It's called Joe Ditzel Has Some Problems 3. I'm gonna put that as a tag, and also let's see. Joe Ditzel has some problems around the house. It doesn't really fit, but again, I'll fix it later. All right, billionaire. These are just tags. LA County, LA, Malibu. Record. Home sale. Record. Real estate, rich, filthy rich, wealth. Yeah, and it's done. There you go. We'll fix it later.